actually holding on to this to where it's.
Send a message.
These guys are really cool. So, Red King's Smuggler has double strike.
Essentially.
It doesn't deal first strike and then normal strike.
It deals twice the damage.
But when you play it, I guess you can call it a wish board.
And you create a card in your hand, either red or green, in your wish board. So I'm going to go ahead and play a Justice here.
Filter that away.
Poison.
This is actually really good. When it enters, it attaches to your opponent.
It kills whatever creature you target with.
Does F-line.
The opponent cannot play a copy of that until this is dealt with.
If it's dealt with, they also get a 3/3 flyer. This is really good anyway.
Empowering is landfall.
Endurance is pseudo vigilance.
You tap it, but it untaps at the beginning of the next turn.
This is a new card type that was introduced in this most recent pack.
So the way that this works is
the big number two there.
That's its toughness, essentially.
When you play it, you get one of the three spells, either lingering influence, sabotage, or swear vengeance. Every upkeep, you get another one that you haven't already used. On the third upkeep after you've played it.
You get a flying lifesteal with revenge, when it dies, it gets shuffled into the top 10 cards of your library. When you draw it, it automatically comes right back into play.
So I think I'm going to take this.
And then turn.
I hate that guy's ability, Warcry, should never have been created. When you're playing in a digital game like this, you can create abilities that are completely and totally busted.
And Warcry is one of them.
When it attacks, the top creature of your weapon or your library.
+1/+1
That does stack.
So if I don't block it here, it attacks, and he hasn't drawn a creature.
The creature keeps getting larger and larger. So I'm gonna go ahead and block.
See, that transformed into a completely different spell. I get to make three cards. One of your units is an enemy player. You play a 1/3 dude that has to attack every turn.
If you summon him, you play 5/5, has charge, trample, charges haste. And at the end of turn, sacrifice. Tribute, if you've had a dude die that turn. You get two of the 5/5 instead. Really good card.
Really good card.
Let's
7-drop gear,
let's see.
As you remove
a creature,
give one of your dudes +2/+0.
Draw one of the top four cards in your library and put the rest on the bottom. And then, after when it goes off,
you may sacrifice another
unit. Draw
another card.
And he's a 4/6 on block.
Seven's
reasonable on this bag. I think I'm gonna take the
pass
turn.
Okay, answer
for days.
You run
five pass turn.
I'm going to target myself.
Trust in the light.
My yard.
Zoe and Marshall Iron are my two choices here. Nothing to do with that.
Zoe brought me back another
Christian bro.
I like that.
I'm going to play this.
What they call relic.
Essentially says,
We'll blaze a path.
My dudes get double their power.
No. Landfall, destroy your creature.
So, I'm just going to light up one of those guys.
I think the three.
I play that guy first.
There's a reason why.
Play an additional copy of whatever power.
Okay, the relic I have has the power. Destroy target creature.
So basically, right now I've got a combo.
I play a power, I get two copies of that power.
And destroy two creatures.
However, next thing I'm going to do is draw a card.
Vara's decent.
But in order to play Vara, I have to have two more power.
The other one was the toughest, a little bit too high for me to deal with.
With anything other than block.
Vara, life steal.
Life win.
Nothing can have.
Roll proud.
Where
it can only be targeted by you, not your opponent.
In summon, the enemy player must either choose to sacrifice a creature,
or she gets death touch and +2/+2.
Now it's my turn.
Give him a choice. He chose the bigger pick. I'll end turn. All my needs get bigger.
The abilities are relatively self-explanatory.
So I'm going to run a few more games of this gauntlet, stop this video, start another one, finish the gauntlet, and then my quest, that way you've seen some testing, I've explained what's going on, and you can actually understand why I'm going to be playing the way I am, but I'm going into the player versus player.
So I can clear out my daily quest, get my first one of the day.
My quest today is to get two lands with a shadow deck. And it was black.
All intents and purposes.
all intents and purposes for the magic players out there.
So we're gonna go ahead and probably play up the silver on this.
And then switch. It does give me all my power.
Those horns!
attack for 5 every turn. It's really good. Really strong.
Meet my axe!
Just 5. So now I scry 3. No. What's the next? Thank you. There's my this on it. No more my skill for you. Big six here, but that's okay.
Give me even more power. do I want to do one more? No, that was this one. My friend. So, go ahead and break here.
And we're going to be back with a punch.